This is Lord Arman of Dark Funeral, and you're watching The Offering.
You're back touring in North America, this time on the Devastation on the Nation tour. How is this new experience for you?
Well, it's a great tour, and it's great to be back. And I didn't really expect much of this tour, but it's been fucking amazing so far.
And it's a celebration of extreme metal, really, so it's kind of a strong community, right?
Yeah.
So, your latest album, Where Shadows Forever Reign, was released in 2016. Now, how you feel about this album?
Yeah, I still feel very strong about it. It's a great record, and it still represents me at this time being, you know. I really enjoy playing the songs live, and I think looking at the crowd response to new songs are really one of the most popular songs that we play.
And it was also the first album with your new vocalist. I was working with him on that.
It was really good. We found a good chemistry and a way of, you know, working on this new record. So it was an easy working relationship too.
And as you imagine, everybody wants to know when we can expect the next Dark Funeral album, right?
I start receiving that question quite a lot.
Yeah.
Well, as you see, we're on tour now, and we're going to continue to tour the rest of the year. Plan is to start taking it easy next year and focus on a new record.
But have you had time to develop some ideas already?
Yeah, I've recorded some ideas, so I'm not flat. But yeah, we've been touring too much, and it's been just not enough time to focus on writing new music. And I prefer to take one thing at a time.
Now, when you start working on an album, do you like to have a precise concept in mind, or you just go with the flow?
Normally, I go with the flow. I have ideas where I want to go, but you never know where you're going to go when you actually start writing. But of course, it's good to have some kind of ideas. But I used to say, whatever, you know, comes out. I can't really do much other than that, you know.
You don't like to plan much.
No, it's just whatever comes out, and that's the way I work. But I need to be in a certain state of mind when I write music, and every note need to have a meaning for me. So it's very important. That's why I don't want or can write when I'm too busy touring. You know, when I'm on tour, I want to focus on that and do a good job and give my best on stage every night. And when I write music, I just really need to sink into my own world and focus on that.
Now, it's been 25 years of Dark Funeral. Did you do anything to celebrate the anniversary?
Did we?
Not really.
Oh yeah, well, we did a Swedish tour, right. Special setup for that, and we're also going to release a box, LP box and CD box with Central Media. I think it's coming out in June, so in a couple of weeks.
And after so many years, when you look back at the entire discography, how do you feel about it? Do you still identify with every album?
Yeah, it's each album is a big part of me, but of course, you know, each album reflects the era of time it's being written, and of course I'm a slightly different. I'm still pretty much the same guy I was 25 years ago, but of course you change a little bit and you get more experience and you know, life takes different turns and you learn from that and get into a new state of mind and stuff like that. So of course, with a new record, I think that represents me pretty well, where I'm at this point in life.
At this point of your career, what do you enjoy most about being a musician?
I think it's... I feel very privileged, and I think it's a luxury to be able to tour all over the world, you know, see so many places and meet so many new people and try different kind of foods, you know, all those small things that just, I like being out on an adventure, I guess. I mean, you need to like that kind of lifestyle if you're going to be a touring musician.
And plus, you're still today a very influential band, so many new bands are inspired by you. How do you feel about that?
I don't know, really. I do understand in a way, but I still have a hard time connecting me with the, yeah. I receive lots of emails with from other younger bands, and I always used to tell them the way I think myself is, of course, you can respect other bands and musicians and think they are really good and talented, but try to find your own style and your own way of writing, and it doesn't matter if it's on, as long as you're satisfied yourself with what you're doing, then it doesn't matter what anybody else thinks. You always need to have that as a first thing. And I mean, I normally say I'm just, you know, I never really wanted to be in a band like this, so for me it's just like did something that just ended up getting quite popular. But I'm not writing for that, and you never know what people are going to think of what you write, the music you write. But we've been lucky that, yeah, lots of people like what we are doing, so.
Definitely, and you know, obviously the music scene keeps on changing, the music industry, etc. Do you miss anything of the early years of the band?
It's hard to say. I'm not the one who look back in time. I'm here and I focus on the future, and I'm trying to, you know, stay focused on that.
You're not nostalgic?
Not really.
And everybody talked about the movie Lords of Chaos. I know you watch it too. Do you think that because of that movie, people who never listened to black metal will kind of try to check it out?
Of course, it's going to attract a whole new audience and lots of new people, for sure. Other than that, I don't know. I mean, it's a weird movie. The only thing I feel was, you know, the chaos that was around at that time and all the partying that was going on and stuff like that, that were things that I could connect to and recognize. But it was lots of things that I felt was a little bit, maybe not 100% correct.
But it was still like a movie rather than a documentary.
Yeah, for sure. So. It was not a documentary, so as a movie, it's fine, but yeah, let's leave it like that.
But maybe, I don't want to say it's going to get mainstream, but you know, some mainstream people are going to maybe be curious about black metal because of that.
Yeah, but I mean, it's out there, and there's really nothing I or anybody else can do about it. So, yeah, I don't know what to say. I mean, I would still do what I always done. So
right,
for me,
regardless.
For me, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, makes sense. And you and the band are very active on social media. So, what do you think about the importance of social media for bands today?
Well, I guess it's important, but it's also an easy way to communicate with people. And also, you know, we're a band that have lots of fans in countries that we never visit. So, and also people have different kind of problems to be able to go out to the show. And I receive lots of mail from lots of people who say that, thank me for doing the social media, because that helps them in their daily life, and also helps them sort of see what's going on outside their own world.
Yeah, it's just, you think it's very important to use it to connect with fans more than anything else?
Yeah, I mean, as I said, everybody isn't fortunate to be able to come out to our show. Some people live in really fucked up countries where we're never going to be able to visit. And also, we can't visit every city on this planet, so. And we still have fans all over the world, and, you know, even in some of the fucked up countries are really closed. I really don't like, you know, being so, you know, up in everybody's face like that. But I mean, still you have to do things you don't really like that much.
But I think you do a good job. I follow your post. It's cool.
Yeah, I'm trying to keep it on a certain level. And
yeah, yeah, exactly.
I don't want to be too personal because I also want to have a very strict with my private life.
And well, yeah,
I really want to have a private life. But it's like when I'm on tour, then I'm on tour.
Yeah, and, your life is the tour.
Then it's part of the job to meet lots of people and, you know, to front the fans and stuff like that. Then it's easier to share. But when I'm home, I try to keep fairly private because I like to separate my private life and the band life, and that's very important.
Of course. And you were saying you had other touring plans after this one.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
I can't say everything because
it's not announced yet.
Some of it is not announced, but we're going to Australia, and there's going to be some more stuff.
Okay. Do you think you'll come back here anytime soon, or after the next album, probably?
We'll see. I mean, we have visas to February 2020. So if there is an offer coming in, you know, before that, then we're just a flight away, you know, basically. We don't have to apply for new expensive visas.
Right, which is always a problem for European bands.
Yeah, it's quite expensive these days, and it's not getting better. But as I said, we got visas for until February 2020, so if there's offers, we're ready to come over.
So with all these tours that you've been doing, is it hard for you to put together a set list?
Yeah, it's always difficult. Because you also want to, for this, we try to change the set list quite a lot from the last tour we did, but you still have certain songs that you know that the crowd really want you to play. But you can't play all of them, but we try to make a good mixture from all the records and then try to make some kind of variation if you come back to the same country.
But is there a song that you personally feel should always be on the set list? Maybe you just like to play it all the time for yourself,
there's really no song that I feel has to be there. It's more maybe the fans do have that feeling rather than
probably.
Me.
Because probably it's all they're all your songs, so for you it's kind of
hard. Yeah, of course, some songs feel more personal than others, but I like to play most of our songs, really. So.
When you think about the future of Dark Funeral, is there something you would like to achieve that you didn't yet?
Well, I'm never satisfied.
Never.
The day I'm satisfied, you won't see me on tour anymore. So, but I don't see this happening in the future.
So continue until you are inspired.
Yeah, but that's just part of me. That's the kind of person I am. I can be satisfied, but I'm not fully satisfied. I'm always striving to better things and do things bigger, more, whatever. If it's the band or in my personal life.